Comme Christian l'a dit, on a fait beaucoup de chemin dans notre lutte contre la COVID-19. Avec des millions de gens pleinement vaccinés, le Canada est un leader mondial, la vaccination. Mais notre lutte n'est pas terminée. Depuis le mois d'août, on travaille pour mettre en place des mesures de vaccination qui vont assurer votre sécurité et celle de votre famille. Ces mesures vont aussi vous permettre de reprendre vos activités préférées. Aujourd'hui, on remplit deux de nos principaux engagements, la vaccination obligatoire pour les employés fédéraux et la vaccination obligatoire pour les voyages. Christian has outlined what the mandatory vaccination that's in place immediately for federal employees will look like. The bottom line, proof of vaccination will be required by no later than the end of this month for all federal employees. And by mid-November, enforcement measures in place will make sure that everyone is vaccinated. This is about keeping people safe on the job and in their communities. And the same goes for the second commitment we made, mandatory vaccination on travel. By the end of October, everyone 12 or older on a plane or train within Canada should be fully vaccinated. There will be a short period where people who are in the process of getting vaccinated can show a negative COVID-19 test, but by the end of November, if you're 12 or older and want to fly or take the train, you'll have to be fully vaccinated, as will staff. Testing will no longer be an option before boarding. À la fin du mois d'octobre, toute personne âgée de 12 ans ou plus voyageant à bord d'un avion ou d'un train devrait être entièrement vaccinée. Pendant une courte période, on va permettre aux gens qui sont en processus de vaccination de montrer un résultat de test de dépistage négatif, mais à la fin du mois de novembre, vous devez être entièrement vacciné, tout comme les membres du personnel. Et le test de dépistage ne sera plus une option. If you've done the right thing and gotten vaccinated, you deserve the freedom to be safe from COVID-19, to have your kids safe from COVID, to get back to the things you love. And if you haven't gotten your shots yet but want to travel this winter, let's be clear. There will only be a few extremely narrow exceptions, like a valid medical condition. For the vast, vast majority of people, the rules are very simple. To travel, you've got to be vaccinated. These travel measures, along with mandatory vaccination for federal employees, are some of the strongest in the world. Because when it comes to keeping you and your family safe, when it comes to avoiding lockdowns for everyone, this is no time for half measures. Already, we're delivering on the first of our vaccine commitments, and in the weeks to come, we'll get the job done on a vaccine passport for international travel. We'll be there to foot the bill for provinces and territories that roll out proof of vaccination programs, and we'll introduce legislation to make it a criminal offense to threaten or harass healthcare workers. Les Canadiens ont remis notre gouvernement au travail pour en finir avec cette pandémie et pour avancer vers des jours meilleurs. On va faire le travail en matière de vaccination. On va rendre la vie plus abordable pour la classe moyenne. On va prendre des mesures ambitieuses pour le climat, tout en créant de bons emplois verts, et on va avancer sur le chemin de la réconciliation. Il y a beaucoup de travail qui nous attend. C'est pourquoi, plus tard ce mois-ci, on va assermenter un nouveau Conseil des ministres afin de mettre en œuvre notre plan progressiste. Je suis très enthousiaste à l'idée de tout ce qu'on peut réaliser ensemble. Before I take questions from the media, I want to address the issue of last week. Traveling on September 30th was a mistake, and I regret it. The first National Day of Truth and Reconciliation was a time for Indigenous people and non-Indigenous people alike to reflect and connect, think about the past, but also focus on the future. I want to thank Chief Casimir of Tkamloops for the conversation we had over the weekend, in which I apologized for not being there with her and her community for this important day. And I committed to going to visit the Tkamloops Tsuwekmuk community in the coming weeks. There's a lot of work for us all to do, and I'm committed to doing it.